But
hey.
I'm sorry I spiked you, okay? I get so mad and I can't control things, and then, you know, shit just falls on top of me. My life sucks right now, and I don't know what to do except I want to say I love you and hug it out. But all that wimpy shit is just, well, I'd say gay, but I have some friends who are gay, so that's not cool anymore. And the ones that I don't really like, it's not because they're gay. So, lame, all right? You are just a lame and angry psycho sometimes. You do bad shit and things. I don't know if I love you, and I'm pretty sure I hate you a little bit, but I'm just so fucking upset that we can't even see each other. And you're just a drunk, lame dad.
You know what? That might just be the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me.
So will you buy me a car?
What?
I mean, not in the so will you buy me a car kind of way, in a completely off-topic can you buy me a car. I mean, firstly, I'm a fat shit that you ruined. And secondly, I will get a job and I will stop smoking pot in that sort of way, okay?
I love you too, son. Now, go. Get a job, because I don't have the money to buy you a car. Besides which way, I'm probably gonna be dead in a couple weeks anyway.
Please don't die, okay? Yeah, it's great catching up with you too, Dad.
Yeah. Hey, how's your mother?
Oh, she's great. No, she's not. She's bored. I mean, all this mesmerizing tantric sex she's been having with a much younger, better built, caring and compassionate man is great and all, but what's she gonna do for the other 6 hours of the day?
What the fuck?
I'm just winding you up, you miserable bastard. She's mad at you. She's scared that you're gonna die, and she wants you to go over there and prove that you give a fuck.
All right. I can take a fucking hint. Let's go. We'll get Tracy on the way.
Tracy, on the other hand, she's a star. Sort of.
I think Mom's at Bean Machine.
So, what's been happening?
You know, I don't know, stuff?
No, I don't know.
Well, what's been happening with you?
Thanks. It's
anyone's guess.
Yeah. Yeah, I get it.
You were out of the city?
Sure, you guys were gone, so I thought I'd, you know...
Let's maybe not pretend it was anything to do with us. Those beast Hispanic dudes with automatic weapons and blacked out windows, they kind of made me think it was an involuntary exodus.
Yeah, okay. Hey, that'll work.
There they are, outside. Fabian, too? Oh, what a treat.
Oh, caffeine. Come on. Your curling has been sluggish for weeks.
A little bit less lifestyle guru and a little bit more boy toy, please.
Excuse me, I'm trying to write a screenplay.
Shush,
here.
Woman.
Hey, Amanda. Fabian.
Michael.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Jimmy.
These two. A picture of holistic well-being, I don't think.
Hey.
Maybe they shit once a year between them.
Hey, oh! That's my son!
Amanda, come. I have a new unitard on hold. You must pay for it.
Hey! Hey! Buddy, I'm gonna ask politely that you show my wife a little respect.
Red meat has been blocking your chi as well as your digestive tract.
I ain't even gonna go there. I'm gonna ask you one time, nicely.
Michael, just hit him, please.
Shush, woman!
Anything for you, sweetheart.
I had some really good work there, you dick!
There's a lot more where that came from, Holmes.
Was he alive?
Yeah, he's fine. Listen, Amanda. I'm meaning to say to you, I just...
What he's trying to say, Mom, is that he's a pathetic, old drunken mess, and he needs you. And you could do a lot better than a prima donna yoga instructor with an anal fixation.
Did someone say...
Shut up!
I guess we could try.
All I'm asking for is a shot.
Neutral ground. Dr. Friedlander's office.
It's perfect. All of us. I'll pick up Tracy and bring her there. Meet you?
Fine. All right, you. Come on. Get up, you idiot.
Yoga?
No. No yoga.
All right. You know where your sister is, right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Wait, wait, wait. But what about that sugar, caffeine, and emulsified pig fat flavored beverage I want?
Another time.
Oh.
Come on. I want one too. Later.
I think Tracy's over at the tattoo parlor.
What? Tracy's getting another tattoo.
No, oh God, no. That Laszlo guy's there.
Laszlo? That asshole? What's he want?
It's Tracy that wants something. She wants to get back on Fame or Shame after you and Uncle T cut her cameo short.
Well, maybe we ought to help her out with that.
Maybe we ought to.
Hey, let me ask you. Back there with your mom. That went okay, didn't it?
Anything that ends with Fabian's burst eardrum is more than okay with me.
Yeah, I mean with me and your mom.
I think it's an important first step in, like, the direction of okay, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you mean.
Here's the tattoo shop.
You know, I thought this town would have more weird people.
You should see the girls. All of them are as hot as fuck, and they're all up for it.
I'm looking for something hip that, you know, says I'm capable of violence, but I'm awesome in the sack. So listen, babe, if you want to make it in Vinewood, you got to do whatever it takes, even if whatever it takes is a depressed borderline alcoholic who hosts the third most popular talent show amongst the 40-year-old female demographic.
So, you'll let me on the show if I blow you?
Yes, and if you could wear some black lipstick, the little guy loves the goth vibe.
Oh.
Whoa!
Laszlo.
Dude, that was entirely out of context, bro.
Jim, you find the Inkslinger, sit on him. Laszlo here's gonna have a little cosmetic work done.
No, please.
Whoa, 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 stay put, you lame-ass Mark.
Sure, kid.
What?
Come on! My punk days are long behind! Ow! Are you popping a fucking tent over here, you fucking psycho? Ah! You made me a pouty fucking hipster! Ah! Ow!
Oh, ho-ho, that looks purty. Here, let's get rid of this.
Oh, my God! Papa Bear! What's Daddy Number Two gonna think about this?
Let's not get him involved.
Let's do. Are we gonna match? Get off! Please don't put a gang symbol on me.
Stay there. How about I draw those three little pubic hairs on here, too? There we go.
Oh,
nice.
You got, like, a camera phone or a mirror I can...
Oh, yeah, I'll get you a mirror. Smash you over the head with it. Snip, snip.
Oh, this is a real one-stop shop. Look, we can work this out. Like men, you know, if you catch my drift. Oh, no, that's my signature, my ponytail. Now I gotta get extensions.
No, what you gotta get is my daughter, whatever she wants.
Yeah, without sucking on your piddle stick.
Look, okay, guys, that was a joke. I'm a clown. I'm a sad, lonely little clown.
Hey, you're gonna put her on your show, and you're gonna make sure she looks good.
Look, okay, I got a lot of juice in this town, but I mean, I'm not a miracle.
Just do it!
Yeah.
All right.
All right, Trace, let's go. We gotta get to the therapist.
What?
So, I'll, like, call you or something, okay? Bye.
There's ever a family that needs therapy. My ponytail. How do I look? It's not good, is it?
Who knew you could use a tattoo gun?
It's one of those skills you pick up in prison. You know, inking your name on your cellie's ass.
Ew. Are you serious?
Come on. No. Not quite.
Not to be difficult, but your therapist hasn't exactly been transformational to your mental health. So I don't know why he'd be better positioned to help four dysfunctionals.
Hey, this was your mother's idea.
Well, I guess it beats yoga.
Pop, now he beats yoga. Literally. Like Fabian, around the head with the laptop. Oh yeah, like pow! Our old man released the dude's inner tranquility all over the bean machine baddie.
To be honest, and I know it's karmically bad, but yeah, I fucking hate that dude.
Yeah, I know, right? He's so up his own ass. You're a fucking contortionist. Whoopee. I contort my junk all day long and I don't act all superior about it. Just a little ashamed and empty inside.
Overshare.
Hey, guy was talking smack to you.
I'm sorry about that.
So, there was me thinking that you might have grown in our time apart?
Well, I applaud you, Pop.
Hear, hear. You're like finally, like, using your powers of selfishness and rage for, like, good. Not an objective universal good, but like a subjective what's in our best interest kind of good.
Fuck yeah! Awesome! Let's rob somebody!
Do it, Dad!
Yeah! Do it!
Enough! Okay? I love that we're getting along, but knock it off.
Yeah, don't, like, actually rob a liquor store. That might, like, kill the mood.
Fucking therapy. Let's do that shit.
Hey, how about you just let your mom and me talk, okay? We got some issues we gotta iron out. And seeing as you two aren't into it, you can just sit there and be quiet.
That's cool with me.
I got all the prescriptions I need, at least for the meantime.
Thank you.
How's the bra?
Daddy totes me.
Michael, kids, let's go inside. Okay. I'm fighting.
Amanda!
Hello!
Good to see you again. Michael, I'm so glad. Isn't this great?
Fantastic.
Michael, be positive.
I am being positive. This is me being positive.
Give it up, Michael. The sarcasm. It's one of the reasons I moved out. It's beneath you.
No, it's not, Amanda. Trust me. Nothing's beneath me.
No, normally there's a whore beneath you.
You know, for someone who spends every waking moment working on themselves inside and out, I gotta tell you, the progress has been really fucking slow.
How would you know what progress is like, you stupid murdering shit?
Gee, because all you do is whine at me.
Oh! All I do is whine. Michael, could you please stop murdering people? Michael, could you please stop endangering me and the both of your children? You kill people, and then you sit in the sun and drink and feel guilty about it. That is not work.
I don't see you complaining on the way to the fucking bank. I mean, let's face it, Amanda. We're trailer trash, you and me. We were taught to do this.
Get a center, Michael. You have no center.
How about you suck my cock? Huh? No, wait. We'll both get a center before that ever happens.
You are such a fucking animal, a deranged animal.
You fucking ain't right, I'm deranged. How could I not be?
I should have had you locked up years ago, you stupid shit.
Do it. I'll put you in the fucking ground with the rest of them.
And that's really all the time we have.
Oh.
Great.
I think we made some real progress there. Oh, Michael. I hope this goes without saying, but family work is a little more expensive.
What, double?
Squared.
Of course.
Take care now.
Hey, so you gonna come home with me or what?
Guess we'll give it a try.
All right, then.
Kids!
So, will you drive us home?
You know, there was a moment there. I thought...
What?
I don't know, like maybe we still had a ways to go. You know, like maybe we need more time.
Time for what?
Time to move beyond screaming at each other.
That was cathartic.
Catharsis all over my face.
Ooh, I got a warm, fuzzy feeling.
Probably just the meds you raided.
Okay. Cathartic. All right. I just don't want it to be more of the same.
Now you're the one making the demands?
No, not demands. I'm saying you're right. Something was broke, and we gotta work at fixing it.
We do. All of us.
Yes, Mom.
For real, peeps.
Because I started to understand something in there. No one else gets this family. Not Dr. Friedlander, or my yoga teacher, or our tennis coach, or the juice guy, or the dog walker.
Hey.
Or Jimmy's third grade teacher.
Or the trash guy.
Or Dad's proctologist.
Or the guy that thinks he's Jesus on Vespucci Beach.
Or the hippie bum who thinks the world is ending.
We're stuck with each other. I mean, how do you explain faking our deaths, changing our names, all the lying to the FIB? That monster, Trevor.
There's no explaining, Uncle T.
Hey, is he coming to the next therapy session?
What? No! Jeez!
Just one thing, Michael. Don't get us killed. And don't get killed. Can you do that?
I'll give it my best shot. With every fiber of my being, I will do whatever it takes to make sure it doesn't happen. Promise.
And no more hookers. Or other women.
Yeah, Dad! Gross!
You're better than that, Pop.
Guys, I'm not really comfortable having this conversation.
Just keep it in your pants, okay?
Yeah, it's so demeaning how you treat women.
Here we are. Home sweet home. Remember this place?
Kids, rooms. If you find dead bodies, cheap women, or Trevor Phillips, we're checking into the Rockford Hills Hotel.